Hello, I'm Tomislav Veg, 3D artist from Croatia. Tonight I'm going to show you my process of portrait sculpting. The person I'm going to sculpt is Sitting Bull. He is a leader of, he was leader of Lakota tribe. Here are his reference photos I will use in the sculpting process. I will move the photos to the right to my second monitor, and as you can see here I already have ZBrush open, so I will start with sphere, NX sphere inside, make it polymesh 3D, go to unify, turn on X symmetry, change material, go to change draw side, enable first dynamic perspective, change draw side to 30, change light, enable second light so we can see better what is going on. So first I will also go to dynamesh, enable it on some 50 resolution, 48, so I can start sculpting now by using only move brush. But before, one more time, unify frame by using only move brush, so I can determine the shapes of his head, rough shapes, the anatomy and stuff. So I will try to talk as much as I can during sculpting process, but I will not make many promises because it is hard to, my brain is not wired to do so, to be able to speak and work at the same time, but I will do my best. Let me play some music in the background. Done so I can concentrate better on this while I talk. Very rough shapes now at this stage. Just to get something that will look like human head. That is the first step. But also at the same time, looking at reference photos, not to waste time. When you see the resolution is going down, sometimes waiting with standard brush and sculpt just to get some shape. Enable mask lasso to elongate the areas that I need. just installed new version of ZBrush today, and I can't find the simple shapes where they are, so I'll just improvise. I will do that later. I'll improvise this time and get the neck this way. The sculpting process will probably take several days, since I don't really have good reference photos, like side view, perspective view, and so on. So it's going to be difficult to achieve likeness. The process I'm doing is called digital sculpting. It is actually sculpting, but only in digital space. Increase the dynamic a bit more to something around 56. Yeah. I randomly change, I know shortcuts on the keyboard, so I change between brushes. Now it's clay build-up brush. I mostly use move brush, clay build-up brush, and standard brush. Also damn standard brush. Was war chief and medicine man. He fought against Custer in Battle of Little Big Horn, where his forces defeated the Americans, annihilated them totally, completely. It was one of the worst defeats of American army in history. So everyone died. So he was not a nice man. He defended his home, but he was a ferocious warrior. I tend to keep it at this stage as long as I can. Don't forget to save the file. Thank you. ears. Now I'll split them. New gizmo in ZBrush. I don't know how to change it to be like the old one. I need to see how to do that later. If I find the sphere, where is the sphere? Oh, here they are, primitives. So, where is this? The sphere. Sphere? Okay. Go. Spoon. I don't like this gizmo at all. Now this will work. No, it won't. See the side of the eyes. I think this is rather good. We need to adjust the calibre. Now go and see my reference over here a bit closer. Okay, so I see more of what is going on here. So remove this. This will work. Smoothing as I go, smoothing things down. Here I need to increase resolution. See the ears. Too big. I don't have good reference for this because his hair is always covering, but I see some parts of it in reference photos, and I see smaller hairs should be also shapeful. But his skull is completely wrong. Switching between them standard and clay buildup brush. I'm also using smooth, but I can see I don't have enough resolution, so I will try to use this new feature of ZBrush called Sculpt this Pro mode. So let's see what can I achieve with that, and I like it. So for large shapes, big changes, I turn off Sculpt this Pro mode. For small changes, small pieces, I turn it on. I will later increase Dynamesh resolution even more, so it will ruin some of the details probably. See, but it doesn't matter, I will fix it later anyway. This is just for me to see where I'm moving, what is happening. Okay, this was autosave, so the sculpt disappeared for the moment. To change this, to use this horrible new gizmo, I don't know. I will need to pause the video to find out how to, because I can't work like this. Okay, I was able to find where to change this, so I can finally work with this. So I can, as you can see, transpose line. This is what I was used to work with. It's much more intuitive to me than the new gizmo. See, his eyes are Oh yes, by the way, Gizmo, these lines is change over here, you see. Just toggle this and you can go back and forth. It's very simple, but this is my first day in latest ZBrush, so I didn't know. Not there. It's too big. Very hard without. No, it is too small. Very hard without the side view. What? His head overall is too wide, although there are various references. On some his head is a bit wider, on other it is more narrow, but I think this head is more closer to reality, because there is one photo with a very narrow head, but I think that is a camera exposure or focal lens. It depends how big or small it was, or focus or whatever. Those of you who are doing photography will know better what it is, but more natural look is always the larger focus focal lens. Using clay build-up brush, damn standard brush to shape. Eyes are completely wrong. Thank you. are some symmetry irregularities on his actual face, but symmetry is going to be broken near the end. Now I will go and increase dynamesh resolution again. For some reason it got turned on. We just sculpted with Sculptis Pro mode, which is much higher resolution, as you can see. Those are the polygons of Dynamesh, and those are the polygons of Sculptis Pro. So let's see what will Dynamesh do now. Oh, it remesh everything. Never mind. It is still good. This is exactly actually what I need. I don't need those tiny details yet. See, some error in ZBrush is still here. Sometimes when you drag, gets across entire sculpt. It's not a big deal, just not do it once and good to go. I'm smoothing things out, looking it from other angles. Here, I would think, what will I do? Will I do sculpted here, or will I leave it both and go with some X-Gen stuff or something like that for the rendering? But I will think about that tomorrow. Well, maybe both. Why not? Let's see. Now I feel I have too many polygons. 150,000. This is for such large movements. It's too much, but I can still do it. It's no biggie. Ears with the head together, just let me try to figure out the shape. At least this position is should go down on this and more like this, I think. And more like this. That's some resolution. Plugin, just sometimes Windows takes subtop master. Sometimes Windows disable vacuum in ZBrush and takes over its pen properties inside ZBrush. So I need to minimize and go back. Merge only, merge and delete extra subtools this time, because I don't like when I have this clutter here. I need to re-enable symmetry now and dynamesh it again, because now we have new subtool. New subtool doesn't have okay. I don't need this anymore. Okay, now we. This is one mesh now, and I will add details to the ears. Just regular ears, because I don't see them on any of the photos I looked on the internet. I don't see his actual ears, so I need to improvise something. fingers or ears in general. There is no, some are really freakish, but in general ears or ears. Masking back face mask for my clay buildup brush, because if I don't do it, I'll when I sculpt, when I sculpt, this happens. You see, very thin line polygons. So when back face mask is enabled, this doesn't happen. It's hard to explain, but once you start sculpting, you will see what I'm talking about. Okay, his nose is not good. Okay, here, oh, yes, yes, yes. Mask the area so I can bring the lips up a bit here. I go back and forth randomly on parts which I see on the face. He has a big nose. There is no doubt about that. Carved this out with some clay build. This is a difficult sculpt, mostly due to lack of good references. But also, his face is very, very okay, so we have something. I think I will wrap it up for today and we'll continue tomorrow where I stop now. So see you guys tomorrow.